The New Orleans Pelicans had lost five in a row. Zion Williamson was saying troubling things at the podium. And then they go out and they plaster the Dallas Mavericks 131-110 on an NBA in-season tournament group play night of all nights. Jake Madison from Locked On Pelicans joins me now. And Jake, this has been a tough team to get a grasp on because they started off the season. You're like, okay, this is interesting. And then not so great. And then they have a night like this where you're like, oh, that's right. This is what this team can do. So how are you trying to make sense of the day-to-day with this team right now?
Yeah, it's been a little bit of a roller coaster, but you know, when you look at those Zion Williamson comments, I think it's all kind of encapsulated in that, right? You can take those comments in a variety of different ways. You could look at those as very negative, which is kind of, I think, the narrative that people did. But I think when you also look into it, he's said he's trying to buy in because he does maybe see that there's light at the end of the tunnel, that there is a lot of talent here, that if they do put things together, you can go and have this kind of game where you're up 30 points on the Dallas Mavericks for much of the second half. And so as they started to get a little bit healthier in this game, they had Najee Marshall playing, they had Herb Jones who'd been out the previous game. You see that defense start swarming. It turns the defense into easy offense and they kind of take off. And that's really what happened here. You know, this is why Zion said, I need to be patient. He used the dreaded phrase, right? Trust the process. But this is the process paying off and why you put trust in it. And even though it's been a bit of an up and down season for the Pelicans, one thing that's definitely come out of that locker room is there's a lot of belief in what they're capable of doing, what they're trying to do here. And you saw it pay off. Or we could just say it's the in-season tournament working. Maybe that's just it.
These guys must care so much more about it now, Jake. No, Brandon Ingram, 25 points in this one, also had 9 rebounds, 7 assists, but still can't get the three ball to drop. His shooting has been off to a nightmarish start to the season. This is a solid shooter, and we're talking about a guy who this season right now is shooting 21% from deep. It seems like the offense, it's sort of emblematic of the offense. Like, we know what the talent is, and it just hasn't quite all clicked. What's going on with Brandon Ingram?
Yeah, you know, I think he's still trying to kind of adjust to a slightly different role here. They definitely need him to be a significantly better shooter, and they need him to take more threes than he's doing. I think he's averaging like right around 4 per game. I don't have the numbers in front of me. They want that number to be like 6 to 8 three-point attempts per game, because when you have a non-shooter in Zion Williamson in your starting lineup, in Jonas Valanciunas in your starting lineup, and kind of a non-shooter in Brandon Ingram at times in your starting lineup, there's no space for anyone to operate, and it's why you've seen Zion Williamson struggle, not finish at the rim as well as he does, because he has to go through an extra defender or two compared to other seasons. Same for Brandon Ingram. He can't really get to his spots because the spacing's not there. They need him to just simply be better. It's really that simple. I think they're doing some of the right things offensively, but they just haven't seen some of these players be it at their best. And that's why, you know, if you want to look at a glass half full approach with this Pelicans team, they're five and six right now, and they haven't even come close to scratching the surface of their potential. So if Brandon Ingram does get that three ball to start to fall, that he starts to do it in volume, things are going to open up. You know, I think it'll help when you get a guy like Trey Murphy back too. That's the type of stuff that's going to make the offense click. They're still finding their way a little bit with it, but it simply comes down to your best players need to play better.
What do you make of those conversations and that narrative that is out there, that this could end up just being dismantled sooner than we realized?
You know, I don't think it'd be from a player perspective of someone wanting out necessarily. Look, Zion has said all the right things. He said all the right things for 2 or 3 years now, to be perfectly honest with you. He signed that massive extension that ties him to here. He has no leverage. You know, given how many games he's missed the past 2 seasons, he probably doesn't have the highest trade value around the league either. So the Pelicans would be selling him off at one of the lower points in his career. All that says, like, I don't see anything happening in the next couple of weeks when it comes to this. I think you might be looking at significant changes to this roster should they miss the postseason this year. They definitely have kind of a playoff or bust mentality, and not even just the play-in tournament, but top 6 seed in the Western Conference, which is going to be tough this year given how competitive it's going to be. Yep. And if they miss that, I think they'll look at moving on from one of Brandon Ingram or Zion Williamson, even if there's reasons, health most likely, that they miss the postseason. So I think that's when you'd see something like that happen. Look, you know, there were discussions with Portland about Scoot Henderson for, you know, one of Brandon Ingram or Zion in the past. They've kicked the tires on gauging Zion's value around the league the season before that too. That's been reported. There's reasons I think it could happen. I don't think you're going to hear it from an unhappy player in the next couple of weeks though.